Getting an estimate of your ancestry is as easy as going to the post office. Here's how it works. You can go online and order a DNA kit, or use one that you got as a gift. Once it arrives, open the box and activate your kit online. Simple instructions on the box will guide you through collecting your saliva sample. After you've completed your sample, you put the tube back in the box and send it on its way. Easy, right? But wait, there's so much more. If you've signed up for AncestryDNA, your kit and your DNA go on another adventure. Your sample arrives at a secret clearing location and the boxes are scanned and routed to one of the three testing labs. At the testing lab, workers take the tubes out of the boxes, scan their barcodes, and check to make sure that the tubes are intact. A series of robots take small samples of the saliva, expose it to chemicals, and spin it at high speeds to isolate the DNA in the spit. DNA is then applied to a microchip that reads the 700,000 markers that provide a person's ethnicity estimate. Ancestry compares the data from your 700,000 markers to a database of ethnic markers drawn from more than 350 global regions. It runs this comparison 40 times to get a range of estimates from which to draw a person's final ethnicity estimate. Next, you get an email with the results including a breakdown of ethnicity and a list of close relatives if you opted into that option. But what happens with your DNA data? Ancestry keeps records of your DNA results and the leftover DNA itself. You can request that both are destroyed after obtaining results, or opt to allow Ancestry to share de-identified DNA results and DNA with the company's research partners now and into the future. Ancestry acknowledges that there is a risk its security protocols could be breached, or that law enforcement could obtain a customer's personal and DNA information through a court order.